little servant under your feet. Anyways, I got some like bug. Not like a sick bug, like a bug to do more logic puzzles. Ever since my last video, I don't know why, I just enjoy them so much. It's just like it's something about there only being one right answer, one wrong answer. It just makes everything so comfortably black and white, you know? Maybe I just like logic puzzles. Is that nerdy? Is that nerdy? The answer is yes. Yes, it is. But nothing's wrong with that. And I'm doing it for the art. Alright, I'm doing it for your enjoyment, so how dare you judge me? I'm doing this for you. So fall asleep right now, or else I will continue to do more puzzles. Anyways, if this is your first time seeing these, it's a puzzle concept. There's different categories, and you need to match up the correct combination of categories given story clues. So let's just do a new puzzle. We can just do maybe a 4x4 grid. Four categories of four things each. I'll do it easy and just create the puzzle here. So this story, the backstory is that Gallagher's gym offers person training. Supposedly it's personal. Gallagher's gym offers person training sessions to its members, and unfortunately today's schedule has been lost in a computer crash. Oh no. Help them sort it all out by matching each customer to his or her trainer and session time, and determine what type of exercise program will be the focus of each. So you have to match up the categories. So the customers are Crystal and Danny, to their trainers, Howard, Irene, Kristen, and Lena, to their programs, cycling, free weights, rowing, and swimming, and what time it's supposed to be at, 8:30, 9:30, 10:30, 11:30. As mentioned, you know, everything is completely, I was going to say, independent of each other, but that's not quite what that means, right? I'm saying that each one is specifically one customer is matched up to one time, to one trainer, to one program. There's no overlap. So it's not independent, because that means that there could be overlap, right? They're dependent on each other, I suppose. Anyways, and there's clues here that tell you certain things that they can or cannot be. And then you can solve it with logic based off. What's left is just a good visual representation of the puzzle. So I'll show you here. We can just walk through this one. So, the appointment with Lena is either the session at 11:30 a.m. or the appointment at 8:30 a.m. So Lena is the trainer. Looks like her appointment is either 11:30 or 8:30. So we can, means we can block off. No for 9:30 and no for 10:30, because it's not one of those two. Though we don't know what it is yet. The appointment at 9:30 is either the free weights session or the rowing session. So 9:30 is not cycling or swimming. The rowing appointment is sometime before the lesson with Kristen. Okay, so what that tells you is that, well, first off, the rowing appointment is before the lesson with Kristen, which means that Kristen does not teach the rowing. And also, if the rowing appointment is sometime before the lesson with Kristen, that means the rowing appointment can't be the last time of day if it's before something else. Firstly, Kristen's appointment can't be the first one of the day if there is something else before it. Arnold's session is with Howard. Alright, that just straight up tells us. Okay. The swimming lesson isn't with Lena. Of the lesson with Howard and the rowing session, one is Blake's and one is at 10:30. So what that tells us, one thing, of the lesson with Howard and the rowing session, that means Howard isn't rowing. One is Blake's and the other is at 10:30. That tells you that Blake isn't at 10:30. So of the lesson with Howard, which is Arnold, one is Blake's and the other is at 10:30. Well, the lesson with Howard we already know is Arnold, so it can't be Blake's. So that means that one is at 10:30. You see, as soon as we say that it is something, automatically puts X's in all adjacent rows for that category. So if we don't say that 10:30 is with Arnold, it automatically crosses out 8:30, 9:30, 11:30 with Arnold. If we say that 10:30 is with Arnold, it automatically crosses off Blake, Crystal, and Danny for 10:30, since it's already taken. So if we know the lesson with Howard can't be with Blake, it must be at 10:30. Conversely, that says Blake's appointment must be rowing. If Howard and Kristen don't do rowing, that means we know Blake's can't be rowing. Ermi can't be with Kristen. And if we know 10:30 isn't, well, we already got that with Lena, and no classes are currently blocked off. Actually, if we know that Arnold isn't rowing, we can know that 10:30 isn't rowing. Sometime after Crystal's lesson. Okay. So if the lesson with Lena is sometime after Crystal's lesson, that means Elena's lesson can't be the first one of the day. And Crystal's lesson can't be the last one of the day. Well, proves that Lena, the only time left after going through these clues is 11:30, so she has to be the 11:30 session. And she can't do swimming, so 11:30 isn't swimming. And let's see, Arnold, it's not with Arnold and Crystal. From that yet. Okay, and sometime after Crystal, so Crystal's can't be the last one, which checks out. There's still spots available earlier. Okay, so now that we've done like one pass through, we filled out as much as we can after we go through more of these clues. Now that things are filled out, we're able to really easier, or build upon what we already got, and the clues make more sense. The appointment with Lena is either the session at 11:30 or the appointment at 8:30. 11:30. Okay, we got it. The appointment at 9:30 a.m. is either free weights or rowing. Okay, that, I don't know if we can build off of that right now, because exact time filled out, because it's still open free weights or rowing. We don't know the customer who it is yet for 9:30. It could be Blake. person left for Kristen is Crystal and Blake with Irene. Look at all that. So we know Arnold's at 10:30 with Howard. Blake is rowing with Irene. Actually, we don't know Blake. Does help us out. Okay, okay. Arnold's session is with Howard, okay. Swimming lesson isn't with Lena. Lena is not swimming. Who has Lena? Danny has Lena. So Danny's isn't swimming. Session. So, the one with Howard. So, Blake is a rowing session. And the other is at 10:30. Okay, Blake's not at 10:30. Arnold's is. So, he's rowing. Okay. This session with Lena is sometime after Crystal's session. Yeah, Lena's session is 11:30, so Crystal's has to be before that, which it is. Okay, I feel like I'm missing I am missing things on the trainers and the programs. Okay, so just keep going through the clues. The appointment with Lena is either this session at 11:30, the appointment at 8:30. Okay, we got it. Being 11:30. Check. And we know. So it can't be rowing or swimming. So that means we know Lena can't be rowing or swimming. Which means that rowing has to be Irene's. And we know Irene is with Blake. Okay. Rowing is Irene's and Irene is Blake. But we don't know what time it is yet. Well, actually, it can't be 10:30 because we know Blake can't be at 10:30. So Irene is rowing. Okay. What else can we deduce? Session at 9:30 is either the free weights or the rowing. Rowing does fit. They both still fit for 9:30. The rowing appointment is sometime before the lesson with Kristen. As long as Kristen is still, could be at 10:30, Erwin could be at 9:30 or 8:30. Arnold's session is with Howard. Great, swimming session isn't with Lena. And we know Lena is at 11:30. And so 11:30. Swimming. Right. Of the lesson with Howard in the rowing session. Howard can't be rowing. One is with Blake and the other is at 10:30, so Blake is rowing. The lesson with Lena is sometime after Crystal's session. Missing. So 10:30 is Arnold. Oh wait, yeah, if we know Arnold is at 10:30 with Howard, so we know 10:30 is with Howard. That means we know Irene is at 8:30 and Kristen's at 9:30. I just wasn't filling it out all the way. And if we know Irene is is with Blake. We know Blake's at 8:30. Crystal's at 9:30. And if we know 8:30 is Blake in rowing, we know that's rowing. 10:30 is has to be Arnold in swimming. 9:30 has to be free weights. 10:30 has to be cycling. Look at that. We got all of the answers. As long as we have the top row, it says exactly what times each one is and what category it is. We're set. We're golden. Look at that. We did it. 8:30 a.m. is Blake with Irene and they're rowing. 9:30 a.m. is Crystal with Kristen and they are doing free weights. 10:30 is Arnold with Howard and they're swimming. 11:30 is Danny with Lena and they're cycling. Submit. Congratulations, I solved the puzzle. Hooray. Of course, I'm in the very slow category, but that's fine. 75% of the people succeed. Takes on average 228 seconds. Record time is 50 seconds. The very slow side, but we are doing this for ASMR, not doing this to set any records here. I am doing this for your relaxation only, so keep that in mind if you ever want to think I'm going slow. Alright, solve this puzzle, or solve a new puzzle. Okay, that was pretty good. You know, let's do a moderate one, or should I make it just do 4x5, so that just means per category there's 5 things. Just makes it a little bit more difficult as there's more variables. So now there's more things here. Okay. Here's the backstory. Belfry Books has several projects that need to be translated into English from various foreign languages. Using only the clues that follow, match each project to its translator, publication year, the length of each in pages, and which language that it comes from. Okay, so we have 5 different translators: Andy, Delia, Ebony, Preston, and Zachary. Published in 2004, 2005, 2007, 2008, and 2012. From the language Arabic, Hebrew, Italian, Japanese, and Thai, they are 150, 175, 200, 225, and 250 pages. See, I'm so slow because I have to explain it to you guys. Maybe if I wasn't doing an ASMR video, I would just hop right in and definitely not want to know the backstory and take my time. But I'll just keep telling myself that it's the video and you guys that are holding me back from becoming the true Logic Puzzle Champion. Anyways, so just a lot of the similar logic that we used in the last puzzle. Just get started with the clues of Preston's project in the book published in 2007. One is in Hebrew and the other is 225 pages long. So that tells you that Preston's project is not the one published in 2007. Also says the book in Hebrew is not 5 pages. Zachary's assignment isn't in Thai. Alright, we can just cross that off then. The Hebrew assignment is 25 pages shorter than the book published in 2008. So the pages just happen to be multiples of 25. So we don't know exactly, but we do know that the Hebrew one couldn't be the longest tells us if the book from 2008 is 25 pages longer than the Hebrew book, and the max length of the Hebrew book so far is 200 pages, that means the max length of the 2008 book has 225, and it can't be 250 pages. The book published in 2004 is either the 200-page project or Andy's assignment. It doesn't really help us right now. Actually, that tells us that 200-page project is not Andy's project. The 225-page assignment was not published in 2012. Okay. The Italian project is longer than the book published in 2018. Okay, or 2008. So it tells us, for one, the Italian book isn't the shortest. It's at least longer than one of them. It tells us that 2008 isn't the Italian book. And it tells us that 2008... I guess it could be. If it's max of 225, then the Italian one could be 250. So... nothing else yet. Of the book published in 2012 and the 200-page assignment, one is in Thai and the other is assigned to Delia. So that tells us that 2012 is not 200 pages, and that the Thai one is not assigned to Delia. To tell you, nothing's blocked off yet. The book published in 2007 is 25 pages longer than Andy's assignment. Okay, so the book published in 2007 means it can't be the shortest, because it's more than Andy's. And if Andy's can't be 200, that means 2007 can't be 225 pages. Also tells you that Andy's is not 2007. And if one of them is longer than Andy's, Andy's can't be the longest. The Arabic project is 25 pages longer than the book published in 2007. Okay, very similar. I mean, if the Arabic one is longer than one of them, tells you that the Arabic isn't the shortest. Also tells you that Arabic wasn't from 2007. Also, if the Arabic project is 25 pages longer from the book published in 2007, we know 2007 can't be 150, so Arabic can't be 175. We also know that 2007 can't be 225, so Arabic can't be 250. Neither the Arabic project nor the Hebrew assignment is a 225-page project. Well, looky there, on our first way through, we already know then that the Arabic book is 200 pages. And if we just go back, the Arabic project is 25 pages longer than the book published in 2007. 2007 is not 225 pages long. So that must mean that 2007 must be Hebrew. Conversely, that must mean that Preston's project must be 225 pages. Sit next to me. If we know Preston is 225 pages, and that 225 pages can't be from 2007 or 2012, we know Preston can't be 2007 or 2012. Also, it can't be Arabic or Hebrew, so we can cross out Preston from Arabic and Hebrew. If we know 175 pages is 2007, is from 2007, and we know 2007 is Hebrew. We know that 175 must be Hebrew. Yeah. And if we know that a person's the only one that can't be Hebrew. Yeah, okay. I think that helped us out a lot. Preston's project and the book published in 2007, one is in Hebrew, the other is in 225 pages, so Preston's project is 225 pages, and the book in 2007 is Hebrew. Yeah, got it, checks out. Zachary's assignment isn't in Thai. We got that. The Hebrew assignment is 25 pages shorter. That also tell us if 2008 can't be Andy or Preston. So if we know 225 is pressed. page book. 2004 can't be Arabic, Hebrew, or Italian. That can't be Arabic, Hebrew, or Italian. Okay, okay. If 2005, okay. Yeah, good, good. The 225 page assignment wasn't published. Yes, we got that. The Italian project is longer than the book published in 2008. Okay, so 2008 was 200 pages, so that means the Italian must be 225 or 250. That's fine. So that means it can only be 2005 or 2012. So Italian can only be 2005, 2012. Okay, that matches up with what we have so far. Zachary's, which one is 175 pages versus 250 pages, and which one was, oh wait, oh yeah, 2007 versus 2012. Okay, Zachary's assignment isn't in Tai. If Tai is 250 pages, I mean Zachary's isn't 250 pages, which means his has to be 175 and Ebony 250. Firstly, 250, 2012. We got this one. 150 pages. Translated by Andy in 2004 in Japanese. 175 pages. Translated by Zachary in 2007 Hebrew. 200 pages. Delia. Preston, 2005, in Italian, 250 pages, Ebony, 2012, and Tai. Hooray, correct. Still on the slow, but not bad. That one only had a 63% success rate, but did it pretty well. Alright, we got 98 points for that one, that's pretty good. I think we have time for one more. Same size, but bump it up to moderate. You're probably gonna watch me really struggle here. Let's hope not. That Ginger did not talk about Thatcher. The presenter who gave the presentation on BM Thatcher or Ginger, we can't conclusively do anything about the 10-minute time. Though, so, alright, of the student who gave the presentation on BM Thatcher and Krista, one got the A and the other spoke for eight minutes. It tells us that wasn't Krista, so Krista didn't talk about Thatcher. And one got an A, the other spoke for 8 minutes, that meant 8 minutes did not get the A. Okay, but we don't know exactly who is who yet. The presenter who gave the presentation on BM Blair spoke 4 minutes more than the student who got the A minus. Okay, so that tells us at first that the person who spoke about Blair did not get the A minus. Okay. And so Blair, so this is 2 minute increments, so that means if the person who spoke about Blair spoke 4 minutes more, the student that got the A minus, means that Blair couldn't have been the shortest two intervals, and the A minus couldn't be the longest two intervals. Okay. 6. Colleen talked about Blair. Well, that just straight up tells us, okay, that helps us out a lot. Colleen talked about Blair. That leaves the only person to talk about Thatcher. Left is Lucille and Zachary to talk about Pitt. Wow, we managed to fill out a lot of this. I'm only the 6th clue. So Colleen talked about Blair. Well, let's just keep where we are for now, and then when we go back through the clues again, I'm sure having this filled out will help us out a lot. The presenter who spoke for 14 minutes did not talk about PM North. Okay. Zachary spoke 4 minutes less than the student who gave the presentation on PM Thatcher. So I mean, Zachary wasn't the top two highest minutes. And if we know Thatcher was Lucille, that means Lucille didn't give the lowest 2 minutes, I guess, the presentations. The presenter who got the A minus spoke for a somewhat shorter time than the student who got the C plus. So that means the A minus couldn't be the longest, and this C plus couldn't be the shortest. Okay? The presenter who got the D didn't talk about PM Pitt. So Pitt wasn't D. Zachary talked about Pitt, so Zachary didn't get the D. Sorry, Zach. Maybe next time. So the student who spoke for 14 minutes. So we're just going back through the clues. The student who spoke for 14 minutes didn't get the D. Okay. Zachary was either the presenter who gave the presentation on Blair or Pitt. We've confirmed him to be with Pitt. The student who spoke for 10 minutes was either the presenter who gave the presentation on PM Thatcher or Ginger. Well, we know that Lucille spoke on Thatcher. So we know that 10 minutes must have been Ginger or Lucille. Those are our only options for 10 minutes. Okay. Of the student who gave the presentation on PM Thatcher, which was Lucille. So Lucille and Krista, one got the A and the other spoke for 8 minutes. Well, we know Lucille didn't speak for 8 minutes. So that means Lucille must have gotten the A. Thatcher got the A. It also tells us that Krista spoke for 8 minutes. If Krista spoke for 8 minutes, could have been about Blair, and she could have gotten an A. Presenter who gave the presentation on PM Blair spoke 4 minutes more than the student who got the A minus. So Colleen, first off, that means Colleen, she spoke for 4 minutes more than the student that got the A minus. I mean, she couldn't have spoken the least amount. So 12 or 14 minutes still checks out. Also means that she didn't get the A minus. And if she spoke for 4 minutes more, and she could only do 12 or 14, that means A minus could only be 8 or 10. Okay, Colleen talked about Blair. Got it. The presenter who spoke for 14 minutes. Talk about PM North. Okay, yeah, 14 minutes wasn't North. So it seemed easy at first because we were getting a lot of the answers, but this is, must be why it's moderate, because we're not filling in a lot of things. Or actually, let's see. So Krista was 8 minutes, and your only possibilities are Disraeli and North, so we can cross out all of those. If A was Lucille and Thatcher, then we know Thatcher couldn't have been 6 minutes because Lucille wasn't 6 minutes. Zachary had to present for only 6 minutes. This is the only possibility left. If Zachary spoke for 6 minutes and the person who spoke for 6 minutes didn't get an A minus or a C plus, we can rule out A minus and C plus for Zachary, leaving only the B plus for Zachary. So if Zach was 6 minutes, we know he talked about Pitt and got the B plus, we can fill those out. Okay, yeah, making progress here, making good progress. Sweet, tasty, delicious progress. Give me all your progress. Where were we? Zachary spoke 4 minutes less. The student that gave that presentation on Thatcher. If we know Zachary spoke for 4 minutes less, who talked about Thatcher? That was Lucille. If he spoke for six, Lucille had to have spoken for 10 minutes then. 10 minutes we know to be an A in Thatcher. 10 minutes Thatcher and an A. Good job, Lucille. It also means that 8 minutes had to have been the A minus. 12 minutes had to have been the D, 14 minutes had to be the C plus. So if we know that Pitt was B plus, Pitt was B plus. Okay. Krista was A minus. No, Krista was A minus. She spoke about yet. Had it been Disraeli or North? Yeah. We know Blair had to either be 12 or 14 minutes. It's a C or a D. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, look at all this progress. Okay. The presenter who got the A minus. Krista spoke for a somewhat shorter time than the student that got the C plus. That checks out because C plus is 14. Krista was 8. Doesn't help eliminate anything right now, I don't think. We know Colleen. Blair. You got the C plus. Center who gave the presentation on Blair spoke 4 minutes more than the student who got the A minus. We know A minus was Krista at 8 minutes, which means Colleen, who spoke about Blair, had to have been 12 minutes and Ginger had to be 14. So Colleen got the D, and that was so Blair was 12 minutes. North had to have been 8 minutes. Nisrali had to be 14 minutes. We got all the Enjoy it.